ascending tract. Ascending tract consists of various tracts. Those are anterior spinal thalamic tract, lateral spinal thalamic tract, fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cunatus. Ascending tract of spinal cord carry impulses of various sensations towards the brain. Pathway for each sensation is carried by two or three group of neurons. Those are first order neuron, second order neuron and third order neuron. First order neuron carry impulses of various sensations through the receptors, through the sensory neurons towards the posterior nerve root ganglion. These are the first order neurons. Second order neurons are the sensory neurons which are present in the posterior gray horn of the spinal cord. These neurons are transmitted from the spinal cord to the subcortical area below the cortex, that is up to the level of thalamus. Third order neuron, these are traveled from the subcortical area, that is from thalamus to the cerebral cortex. Now we are going to see about anterior spinal thalamic tract. The anterior spinal thalamic tract is formed by the fibers of second order neurons of a pathway for crude touch sensations. In this tract, the situation of the anterior spinal thalamic tract is the anterior wide funiculus near the periphery.
Terminates in the ventral posterolateral nucleus of the thalamus. The neurons of this thalamus form third order neurons. The impulses pass from somatostatic area to cerebral cortex. Cortex now functions of anterior spinal thalamic tract. Carries impulses of root touch sensation. Next, effect of vision. There are two types of effects, bilateral and unilateral. In bilateral vision, there is loss of root touch sensation like itching and tickling. In unilateral vision, there is also loss of root touch sensation like in opposite side by the below the layer of vision.
Now we are going to study about the lateral spinal thalamic tract. The lateral spinal thalamic tract is formed by the fibers of second order neurons for the sensation of pain and temperature. The lateral spinothalamic tract is situated at the lateral column towards the middle side, near the gray horn. The lateral spinothalamic tract is originated from the marginal nucleus and substantia gelatinosa of Rotundo. Course of the lateral spinothalamic tract. The lateral spinothalamic tract has a crossed fibers, axon from the marginal nucleus and substantia gelatinosa cross opposite side and reaches the lateral column of the same segment. Few fibers may ascend one or two segments. They cross to the opposite side and ascend to the lateral column. All fibers pass through the medulla oblongata, pons and midbrain and reaches the thalamus along with the anterior spinothalamic tract.
Effect of lesion. Fibers of lateral spinothalamic tract cause a loss of pain called analgesia and cause a loss of temperature called thermoanesthesia. In the effect below the effect of lesion in the opposite side.
Now I am going to explain you about the major tract of the ascending tract, which is also known as the postural ascending tract. There are of two types: fasciculus gracilis, tract of Gall, and fasciculus cunatus, tract of Burdett. They are situated on the posterior white column. As you can see here, these are the This has a cross section of the spinal cord. The middle portion is known as the white column. The fibers of these two tracts are situated in the white column of the spinal cord. Insertion after entering into the spinal cord, the fibers ascend and some fibers descend. And the fascicles gradually contain the fibers from the lower part of the body, and the fascicles gynecus contain the fibers from the upper part of the body. These are the fibers. You can see here. And after the course, the fibers ascend through the segments of the spinal cord and terminate in the medulla oblongata. Fascicles gradually terminate in the nucleus of the crescent. Fascicles gynecus terminate in the nucleus of the tinnitus. After the nuclear medulla oblongata forms the second order neuron. The axons of the second order neuron form the fibers, which is called the outward fibers. The fibers from the both sides cross the midline. You can see here. After crossing the midline, they enter into the thalamus. From the third order neuron from the thalamus transmits the sensory impulse to cerebral cortex. This is all about the gall and bladder.
Now we are going to know about functions and effect of presence of tracts of gall and bladder. Functions: fine tactile sensation, tactile localization. Tactile localization is the ability to locate the area of the skin where the tactile stimulus is applied while closing the eyes. Tactile discrimination. It is also known as two-point discrimination. It is the ability to recognize two stimuli applied over the skin simultaneously while closing the eyes. Sensation of vibration. It is the ability to perceive the vibrations from a vibrating tuning fork placed over the bony prominence connected to the deep tissues through the skin. Cautious kinesthetic sensation. It is the sensation or awareness of various muscular activities in different parts of the body. Stereognosis. It is the ability to recognize known object by touch while closing the eyes. Effect of lenses. Loss of fine tactile sensation. However, true touch sensation is normal. Loss of tactile localization. Loss of two-point discrimination. Astereognosis. It is the inability to recognize known objects by touch while closing the eyes. Loss of proprioception. It is the inability to appreciate position and movement of different parts of the body. Lack of ability to differentiate the weight of different objects. Sensory ataxia. It is the condition characterized by uncoordinated, slow, and clumsy voluntary movements due to proprioception.